So first question up is from Joey H, and he asked me, he said, what are good protein choices after training and mealtime, and how much protein on a daily basis? So it's a good question, and often a question that I do get asked quite a bit. And what I will say is from the start is that obviously Joey's probably asking me how much protein because he's thinking about gluconeogenesis, which is where we make up carbohydrates from other sources, in this case, which is protein. But what I will say is that I believe that gluconeogenesis is really overstated and overemphasized within ketogenic and low carb communities, because the contribution of gluconeogenesis towards glucose production and carbohydrate production is actually very, very small. And what we also know is that gluconeogenesis is not a supply driven process. So what that means is that just because you eat more and more protein, you get more and more gluconeogenesis. So there's a point where that, where you eat enough protein, gluconeogenesis will just stop because your body is at homeostasis and it realizes it has enough protein. So I believe that the protein restriction for athletes or any endurance athletes and athletes in general, when undergoing an LCHF lifestyle, is one of the biggest mistakes an athlete or an endurance athlete, Ironman athlete, be what you will, can make. So I suggest that you don't really try and restrict protein at all, and you just pretty much eat protein until satiated. Protein is a very satiating macronutrient, so it is actually quite hard to overeat it anyway. In terms of protein choices, obviously, I don't know, I mean, obviously meats, eggs. If you're a vegan, this is where it really becomes very, very difficult to get the correct protein balance and the correct nutrients that are necessary to compete at a healthy and maintainable level. But for me, my personal protein choices are, I do eat eggs. I generally have eggs every day. Obviously, I will sometimes supplement with some whey protein. The SFuels bars have some substantial amount of whey protein in them, and also just general meat. But I also always try and stick to the rule that I always ask myself, okay, what else is this giving me? What is the nutrient density of this food, of this protein when I'm eating it? Is it giving me something else? So for example, we know eggs, as well as being very high in protein, have a number of other properties that are really beneficial for overall health. And another good choice is sardines. Sardines, high in protein, massive other macronutrients, and massive other vitamins and minerals that are also really beneficial for overall health. Great, and thanks for the question there, Joe.